What's going on, everybody? I'm Alex, a doctoral candidate at NUS Business School in Singapore, and in this video, I'm going to briefly present a paper I've written with my co-author Thomas Chermak, a professor at Colorado State University. The paper is titled The Resistance to Scientific Theory in Futures and Foresight and What to Do About It. In this paper, we try to provide an answer to the question, why is futures and foresight not established in academia and therefore in the world at large? Our answer to that question is based on the fact that futures and foresight as a field of study has a set of ingrained norms, beliefs, and conventions that strongly resist the creation of scientific theory on futures and foresight practices and processes, and in particular on the outcomes of those practices and processes. And since we don't have much theoretical foundations of this kind distinct to our field, then we are often seen as a pseudoscience by scientists in other disciplines. So to prove our point, we first explain in detail what is a scientific theory according to mainstream social science research. We explain that a scientific theory is considered as a causal relationship between events and phenomena in the real world, verbally explaining how and why such events and phenomena happen in a logical manner. Then we argue that futures and foresight has been resisting the creation of this kind of theory on the outcomes of futures and foresight practices and processes. And to be clear, when I say on the outcomes of futures and foresight practices and processes, I mean on how, where, when, and most importantly, why futures and foresight interventions, capabilities, and methods actually work on individuals and small groups of individuals to achieve the outcomes that they're supposed to achieve. For example, enhancing individual creativity or organizational learning. But let me give you an example of this kind of theory. An example theory would explain in a way that is distinct to our field, for instance, why scenario planning increases the creativity of individuals who are doing it. Then, to explain why futures and foresight has been resisting the understanding and the creation of this kind of theory, we list 9 closely related reasons or psychological barriers. Let me give you 3 of those 9 reasons from the paper. The 3 reasons I believe are the most crucial. The first reason from the paper that I'm going to share with you is that the term theory in futures and foresight has been used interchangeably to denote general conceptual arguments, epistemological arguments pertaining to how knowledge about the future is acquired, as well as ontological arguments pertaining to what kind of knowledge about the future is there to be acquired in the first place. But very rarely, it has been used to refer to that kind of explanatory theory as in the meaning used by mainstream social science research. And therefore, due to this language convention, our field has resisted the understanding and the creation of this kind of explanatory theory on futures and foresight practices and processes. The second reason I'm going to share with you is that futures and foresight is based on the assumption that a multiplicity of futures needs to be explored, so that the word prediction has extremely negative connotations within the field because that word refers to investigating only one future. Now, a lot of mainstream social science research actually also uses the word prediction to refer to one of the main goals of scientific theory, that is, statistical prediction. So, although statistical prediction is not at all concerned with predicting the future, but only with predicting the outcomes of social science research statistically, this very negative connotation within the field has prevented the understanding and the creation of scientific theory on futures and foresight practices and processes. The third and last reason I'm going to share with you is that given that futures and foresight is a multidisciplinary field of study, and that it is commonly believed that any formal degree in a traditional subject may even be an obstacle to become an expert in futures and foresight, then a lot of people active in the field enjoy being outliers and generally look down on established disciplines in the social sciences. But unfortunately, this outlier approach has also worked in reverse, in that futures and foresight is often seen as a suspicious field of study without any serious theoretical foundations by other disciplines in the social sciences. So if you want to know more about these three and other reasons why futures and foresight is not established in academia and beyond, you can take a look at the description box down below, where you will find a link that will take you to the paper published on the journal Futures and Foresight Science. In the paper, you will also find a set of solutions to the problem of lack of establishment of futures and foresight in academia. If you don't have access to the paper, feel free to reach out to us and we will be more than happy to share a copy of the manuscript with you. Now, just to be clear, this paper is about the psychological reasons behind this problem, which we believe are the most crucial. But for sure, you will be able to find more reasons in other domains. So if that is the case, please engage with us and leave us a comment down below. I hope you will like the paper and I'll see you in the next video.